Welcome to the video lecture series of Grade 10 Chemistry. Today, I'm going to discuss about the lesson Carbon and its compounds. Carbon is a unique element. It's a non-metal and its symbol is C. Carbon gets its name from the Latin word carbo, which means a black rock that can burn. The word highlights a physical property, its color, and a chemical property, its combustibility. Carbon exists in nature in many forms. Carbon is of immense significance to us, both in the elemental form and in the combined form. The important carbon compound is evident from the fact that all the living systems, like human beings, animals, birds, plants, insects, etc., of this universe are made up of carbon compounds, like carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, fats, hormones, nucleic acids, etc. The carbon compounds also known as organic compounds. Besides this, a large number of things we use or consume in our everyday life are made up of carbon compounds. For example, our food materials like grain, pulses, fats, sugar, tea, coffee, fruits, vegetables, etc. are made up of carbon compounds. Similarly, materials like cotton, wool, silk, nylon, terlin, which are used for making clothes are carbon compounds. Dyes we use to brighten and beautify our clothes are again made up of carbon compounds. The fuels such as wood, coal, kerosene, LPG, natural gas, CNG, petrol, diesel, etc., which we use to cook our food and to run vehicles are made up of carbon compounds. Industrial products like soaps, detergents, rubber, fibers, plastics, dyes, perfumes, cosmetics, etc. are all carbon compounds. So most of the medicines like antibiotics, sulfur drugs, analgesic, antipyretics, etc., which we use to protect ourselves from diseases and ailments are again made up of carbon compounds. Thus, we can say that carbon compounds play a very crucial role in our day-to-day life. Carbon forms a large number of compounds that a separate branch of chemistry is required to study them. Since carbon compounds were initially known only in living organisms, the branch of chemistry dealing with them came to be known as organic chemistry. Now, so carbon is a versatile element. The Earth's crust has only 0.0202% of carbon in the form of minerals like carbonates, hydrogen carbonates, coal, petroleum, etc. And the atmosphere has 0.03% of carbon dioxide. In spite of this small amount of carbon available in nature, the importance of carbon seems to be immense. A simple test to identify carbon in a material is to burn it in air so that a colorless, odorless gas will be forming, and that gas is carbon dioxide and it turns lime water milky. Then the given material contains carbon. So in this chapter, we shall discuss the properties of carbon compounds which make them so important to us. Now, usually, the melting and boiling points of carbon compounds are very low. If you look at the table, you can understand that. The melting point of acetic acid is 290 and its boiling point is 391. Then, if you look at chloroform, CHCl3, the melting point is 209 and the boiling point is 334. And for ethanol, means ethyl alcohol, the melting point is 156 and the boiling point is 351. Okay, so overall, we can say the melting and boiling points of carbon compounds are very, very low. Okay, so why this is like that? The reason says that the force of attraction between the molecules are not very strong. There exists a weak force of attraction between the molecules of this compound. Weak force of attraction between the molecules of this compound. That's why the melting and boiling points of carbon compounds are very low. And again, another property of carbon compound is that most of the carbon compounds are poor conductors of electricity. You already know to conduct electricity in a solid compound, it requires free electrons. But in the case of liquids like acetic acid, ethanol, etc., they need ions. Positive and negative ions makes the passage of electricity. In these compounds, actually, they does not give any ions. That's why the melting and boiling points are very low, and usually they are the poor conductors of electricity. So most of the carbon compounds are poor conductors of electricity. Why? Because these compounds are not producing any ions. Usually ions, positive and negative ions, makes the passage of electricity, makes the movement of electricity. So in these compounds, the ions are not present. Okay, that's why they are not conducting electricity. So we learned 2 points from this topic. Now, carbon compounds usually have low melting and boiling point. Why? Because they have, or they exist, weak forces of attraction in this compound. Second point is that most of the carbon compounds are poor conductors of electricity. Why? Because they did not give any ions.